I'm Caleb, I'm 28 years old, and I'm from Chandler, Arizona. I've always been an adventurous person, and I live a pretty hyperactive lifestyle. I also love to travel. I lived in New Zealand for a year. I lived in Thailand for a while. But being on the road can leave me alone for bouts of time. And it disconnected me greatly. So I meditate as much as I can. I'm a very spiritual person. And I like to see how it can guide me and open me up to new awarenesses in life. After meditating for a long time, you have these moments where you almost come out of body. And I could look down and see all my narratives, my mental constructs. It almost felt like I was an alien assuming the body of Caleb. Sorry, that sounded extremely stupid. Meditation also opened me up to ideas like magic and things like the tarot. If you get into anything like, you know, the esoteric world, the occult world, it's one thing to read about it, it's another thing to actually engage in it. The idea behind it is it's largely an experiential reality. The CIA has experimental findings that remote viewing is real. They've done experiments that show this is actually a viable skill. It's just very hard to do well, something you really have to hone. So, you know, the everyday person probably can't do remote viewing, but people who are very skilled in it, there's something to be said for the efficacy of that psi phenomenon. Okay, so looking this over, I see a couple cards that throw me for a loop. The Hermit represents sort of that individual life. It could be seen as that I'm gonna give up my bachelor life. Now that would be a big change for me. When it comes to dating, I guess I get around a lot. I mean, I feel like I can get sex anywhere. I love women and I love to have a little fun. You know what I mean? But I wouldn't say I've been in a long-term relationship before. I'm totally open to it, but I feel like I just hadn't found the right person to settle down with until Alina. Alina is from Russia. She's 27 and extremely beautiful. Alina and I have been together for about a year and a half now, but we've known each other for almost half our lives. I met Alina about 13 years ago on social media when I was around 15 years old. And we started chatting like we were best friends. Talked about just random things kids do. But after a few years of online friendship, we lost touch with each other. Fast forward over the next several years, I was gonna go to Russia and I hopped on a Russian dating platform to see who I could meet. And there was Alina. It was the biggest small world experience. Some visa issues came up and I never actually made it out there. But we kept talking more and more, and I realized that we had something special. Saying, darling, I really miss you. It's strange because we haven't even met, but you're such a major part of my life right now. It's quite hard not having you around. I don't want to wait any longer to find out if Alina's and my connection is real in person. But with COVID, the borders of Russia are closed. So we're going to meet in Turkey and spend 2 weeks together.
I miss you, can't wait to hold you and hug you. So be prepared, okay?
Alina and I have a deep emotional connection, which makes it easy to look past, well, what other people would say is a massive difference between us.
Смотрите на нее. Oh my god!
Oh,
какая дива!
Алина, очень-очень круто выглядишь.
Let's go.
I'm so ready.
Will you slay?
Yes.
Are you a queen?
Yes, I am.
So work it.
I'm Alina, I'm 27 years old, and I'm from St. Petersburg, Russia. I'm a pretty active, energetic, and fun person. Recently, I got very interested in burlesque because it shows that in different body, you can still feel beautiful.
Боже, боже.
She's a model now.
О, сколько у нее лиц.
Stop it, вы меня смущаете. Ну нет, продолжайте.
My condition is called diastrophic dysplasia. It's a form of dwarfism.
It's rare and it affects everybody differently. For a child to be born with this type of dwarfism, both parents have to be carriers of the gene.
It can affect your joints and, of course, your stature.
Unbelievable, Alina.
My hands and my feet look pretty different too, but I don't think disability is a problem. In many areas of my life, I try to do everything, really. I also have a band called BFF Band.
I want to feel a message coming in, your body locking in, vibrating.
Which consists of my friends, Asya and Elijah, my friend who I live with. Singing. When the music goes on, I feel like I can take on the world.
Morning.
Hi. Ой, подожди, а можешь, пожалуйста, подвинуть, там дать эту зажигалку? Да, вот эту.
I'm pretty comfortable in my body. I've already accepted the fact that I don't look like everyone else and I'm just trying to rock what I have.
Я всегда очень боюсь это делать, ты же знаешь.
But there are things that are hard to do.
Oh.
So that's it. How simple is that?
С этим я справилась.
With my hands, sometimes it's a bit hard to do some things because my fingers don't really bend. And I can't walk a lot. So I use a wheelchair for longer distances. When it comes to dating and me being a little person, there also have been some challenges. But I've never dated a little person. I don't know why, but I really like tall guys. But in Russia, a lot of people, they don't take me seriously. They don't treat me as an equal person. But Caleb did, and I'm glad he did. Caleb and I met on social media when we were teenagers, and I was so excited to just add random people to practice my English, and Caleb was one of them. He is handsome, and we laugh at the same weird stuff. He like tries to cheer me up if I'm not having a good day. Sometimes I send him my pictures and he's like, you're a queen. I'm like, yes. It doesn't bother him that I'm a little person. And I really love that about him. I really cannot wait to see how he really is in real life and to touch him and get to know each other for real. I just want someone to be serious about me and be a good partner, supporting each other no matter what. And I think Caleb could really be the one.
I know it's called the situation right now, but if we don't meet now, when?
When will we meet? It's been 13 years. He's gonna become like my long-lost brother. Maybe we'll lose like the spark, and I don't need that. We tried to meet before, but it didn't work out, either for me or for him. And now, oh my God, both of us can do it. Gosh, I don't know. It would be so much easier if he would just come here to Russia. But we don't know what's gonna happen next. Now it's COVID, and then what? I don't know, aliens will come. I really have no clue.
I think we have a really strong connection online. But I'm very worried about how Caleb is gonna see me. He's never been with a little person before, and he hasn't seen how I walk. And I don't know what he will think about it. It's not the confident walk on the runway kind of thing. I don't like how it looks.
maybe he will be overwhelmed. So I'm really scared about that.
In less than a week, I'm flying across the world to Turkey to meet Alina for the very first time in person. I'm excited, but I'm also nervous because this is a unique situation for me. I found out Alina was a little person about 13 years ago when we met on social media. And at the time, it wasn't someone I really gave much thought to. We were just friends online talking. Over the years, we just bonded on a level that I've never experienced before. Just a sense of being heard and understood. I felt like she actually knew me, and our friendship became more romantic. She really draws out the best in me and inspires me to do more with my life, and that's what I want in a partner. This trip is a huge next step for our relationship, and I'm not taking it lightly. So I need to set some positive intentions for a successful trip. The subconscious mind works in images and symbols. This image is a symbolic representation of the word intention. So it's really easy to have an intention and keep it merely in language, but by drawing an image which represents the intention, we're going deep into the subconscious and leaving an impression which can percolate and perhaps come to pass, quite literally or through some form of synchronicities, I'll be seeing this intention manifest itself. I'm going to meditate on it for a minute to really internalize and let the image seep in. And then I'm going to burn it.
I want to connect with Alina, and this picture holds that meaning to me.
So the focus that I'm creating here will carry on into Turkey and into my relationship with Alina in a healthy, natural, cosmic way.
Alina sent me a message this morning saying that there's something she needs to talk to me about. I'm a little nervous. I don't know what this is about. There we go.
You're beautiful. You look great.
How's it going, Alina?
It's going. I'm very excited about our trip. It's gonna be amazing.
Well, I can't wait to get to Turkey and see you. I just want to pick you up, give you a giant hug.
Well, usually, you know, I don't really let people pick me up, but you're an exception.
Excellent.
So, you can. You can. So, I have something to tell you. You know Elijah, my friend?
Yeah.
Yeah, so he's gonna be coming with me.
What do you mean?
Well, the thing is that my mom, she's really worried about me. She's worried that I'm going to a foreign country, meeting you, like you're a guy from internet. And the only way to make her like feel better about this was to bring Elijah along, because she really likes him and trusts him.
I live with my friend Elijah, and I ask him if he can go with me to make my parents feel better. Also, it could be a good thing because I'm gonna meet Caleb for the first time in my life. So Elijah can show him how to help me with the wheelchair and stuff.
I want your family to feel comfortable about you seeing me, of course, but don't you think it's gonna be weird to have Elijah there? I'm going to meet you. Like, who's this third person? We've talked a lot online, but I don't feel like it's the proper time or place for him to come when I'm meeting Alina for the first time of all places. I feel like it might give a weird vibe to the trip. Also, I think looking out for Alina should be my job, so I feel like Elijah's kind of stepping in where he's not needed.
You know, I'm a bit worried about, like, the accessibility in Turkey.
You can walk, right?
I get tired very easily. I don't know, maybe like if I walk for 5 minutes, I'll get tired. And
I'll just carry you. I'll put you over my shoulder and I'll walk you through the forest.
Ooh, so nice. Like princess. But, I mean, like, I know you never had an experience of dating a little person, and that's like probably my main concern.
So give me an idea, though. Like, what type of stuff will you need help with?
Well, of course, I would need you to help me with my wheelchair. Like, to push me or to, like, get it out from somewhere. Or maybe there are, like, some steps and you have to, like, carry the wheelchair. And another thing is, I don't know how it's going to be in the hotel room. Like, will I reach the lights? Will I reach the hair dryer? I don't know. I'm just a bit scared that what if you get annoyed with it?
It's one thing to just see my face and talk to me on a video, but it's another thing to push my wheelchair and help me down the stairs. I know that for people who never encountered it in their lives, it could be really overwhelming.
Now, I think I know what I'm in for to some degree. So I don't want you to worry about that. We'll figure it out.
Yeah, I don't want to get my hopes up too much, but at the same time, I think it's already too high up, my hopes, because our relationship is very valuable to me.
I think it'll be a good time regardless, and we'll make the most of it no matter what. This is a big step, meeting in person for the first time. But I'm realizing I might have to help Alina a lot. And I just wonder what that's going to be like, if that's going to be a problem that I can't really predict. But I'm really hoping for the best, and that our connection will only grow stronger once we meet in person.